already discussed about sports diplomacy. And Sarah pointed out how sports can become an instrument, a device to integrate different nationals and publics. My paper is on a different perspective. I still consider sport as a very important instrument to facilitate public diplomacy, but I use sport events, so global event, how global events can become a forum for network building, and how global publics can come to Korea and build relationship with the domestic publics. So my case I use is the 2002 FIFA World Cup, South Korea, Japan, and I look at South Korea's perspective. So my research questions are, what impacts did this event bring to the nation, and to what extent can we call this event a public diplomacy initiative? And first, I went through some of the main literatures out there, and I went through the concept called the new public diplomacy. So public diplomacy was initially inaugurated by government bodies and ministries. And this has now been transformed to what we call a new public diplomacy, as Nelson says. It's about collaborating between not just government bodies, but a range of different actors. So publics, individuals, and even civil societies can become the main actors playing the public diplomacy game. And as Lana calls it, they can build bridges and also set agendas. So sport, as I mentioned earlier, has always been a crucial part of our life, and therefore we can view this as a very useful instrument to build public diplomacy initiatives. And according to Victor Cha, sport in general is shaped by the political development of a country. And therefore, three components constitute sport diplomacy nexus. So first, the capacity of sport to reflect identity. Second, the capacity to acquire power by hosting sporting events. And this power, as we mentioned, is probably sport soft power. And third, the capacity of sport to trigger ideational changes. So by initiating public diplomacy via sports, we can actually change ideas, change norms. And there's some criteria to qualify an event as a mega event. A mega event is a global event. First, the level of organizational complexity and how many numbers of participants in hosting the event. And secondly, the attractiveness of the event itself are some of the criteria we have to think about when judging the event, whether the event is global or not. And the framework I use is three different pillars in public diplomacy, which is credibility, legitimacy, and relationships. So I use these three pillars to judge whether or not the 2002 World Cup was a public diplomacy initiative, and if yes, to what extent it was. And there's three perspectives. First is, we could say global sporting events are public diplomacy initiatives. So they fully facilitate relationships and the government bodies and also the agencies which host these events have a clear objective, have a clear public diplomacy objective. Secondly, which is sporting events can be regarded as catalysts of public diplomacy, but they're not, during the planning phase, they weren't categorized as public diplomacy initiatives. They had more unintentional outcomes. And third of all, we can just simply exclude global sporting events from public diplomacy, detach the two. So I use these three perspectives throughout my paper and judge and identify which perspective was the case in 2002. And in current public diplomacy, there's three different realms. So there's the contentities, identity and connections. And as we already mentioned, there was the Public Diplomacy Act, which was established last year. And sports and Korean public diplomacy has quite a long, rich tradition. We could say 1988, Seoul Olympic Games, was really the pinnacle of Korean sport diplomacy. It was really the critical juncture where foreign publics started to realize the potential of South Korea. And then after 1988, we had different mechanisms and different schemes to really enforce sports as a diplomatic initiative, but with rather less success because of fragmentation and politicization and bureaucracy within some of these sporting agencies. The FIFA World Cup 2002 was quite a unique event because it was hosted by two countries which traditionally has very contentious political relationship. So there were some concerns by some experts because of some of the political backgrounds and political tensions between the two countries. But all in all, the event itself was a success in terms of this tournament, in terms of sports, sporting the tournament itself and sporting. The impacts, the short term impacts, were quite clear, very positive. So for some experts, they say that GDP growth due to the World Cup effect was 0.6%. It's massive, massive sums. And also, we had the red wave, the street cheering culture. This was really effective in really getting attention by foreign publics, getting attention of foreign media. And somehow, this was the forum for domestic publics to gather with foreign publics as well. But, however, the long-term impacts were more ambiguous. The Korean government tried to use the World Cup to facilitate dialogues with the Japanese government, but especially by using a two-track approach, using the government and civil societies to bond with our neighbor, Japan. But this has been met with rather less success because of historical political turmoil. As you know, Tokyo is one problem, comfortable problem. So it was the question whether or not sports global event has alleviated political turmoil is rather less clear. So now I go into to what extent the World Cup can be called a public diplomacy initiative. And I use the first pillar, which is credibility. So World Cup enabled the facilitation of networks in three ways. So first through the commercial initiatives. So by acting as a forum, different private sectors host of different events, forums, workshops, where masses of foreign publics could join. And also through, as I mentioned, the street sharing culture. And through governmental exchange with elite foreign nationals. And in doing so, gained credibility. And also legitimacy. So legitimacy in sport events means compliance with the internationally approved system, regulated by FIFA in this case. And Korea, Japan has been compliant with these FIFA's regulation and guidance. Therefore, the whole event could call this as a legitimate event. And there's three relationships. Increased interactions reinforce the relationship among agenda centers such as the Korean Football Association, KFA, the Ministry of Culture, Sport and Tourism, and other domestic publics, vis-a-vis foreign ministers, foreign sport agencies as well. So in the short term, Korean-Japan tensions were alleviated in 2002, 2003 as well, but in the long term I said that these effect. It's very ambiguous. And in conclusion, the World Cup did not initially pursue public diplomacy initiatives or objectives, but the outcomes were actually public diplomacy outcomes. So we can say that the three perspectives I mentioned in the introductory phase, number two, can be identified. So number two was that during the planning phase, the government body, the hosting body, doesn't actually objectify or doesn't categorize the event as a public diplomacy event, but the outcomes are unintended and they are public diplomacy outcomes. This was really the case for 2002, and this has built a platform for future, for other Korean sporting events such as the Asian Games in Incheon in 2014. This was, and also the Pyeongchang Olympic Games, which will be hosted next year in January, late January, February. So these two events, you can say, are more public diplomacy initiatives because government bodies had a clear objective to use these events as forums to facilitate relationships and build bonds with foreign publics. So the first conclusion we can make is that 2002 FIFA World Cup has ultimately enhanced Korea's reputation. The second, Korea, as I mentioned, has hosted numerous other events. In 2014, we had the Asian Games. And next year, we're going to host the Winter Olympic Games. And number three, the relationship between sports and public diplomacy, as seen through the case of the World Cup, indicates that sport is mutual and fluid. So it's a very good asset to possess by a country to facilitate dialogues and public diplomacy initiatives. It's also fungible, which means it's very flexible. So it's not politicized, it's not bureaucratic, and it's very much a harmonized instrument. So sport is played and conducted anywhere in the world, not just in Korea. And that's why it can become a building block for future relationships with not just government at a government level, but for individuals as well, and for us as well. So thank you very much.